conference play against the Bismarck Lions. This Bismarck team is a very good football team, kind of used to passing ball so far this year.
Right. Like you said, we're starting our conference play, new season. I mean, Prescott, they've got potential to have a good year. They've got to eliminate a lot of mistakes, mental mistakes that they've made. But Bismarck tonight, this might be another long ball game. They passed for 700 yards in three games. One of their better fullbacks is out tonight. I think he had a little altercation, and in high school you don't get to play the next game. So that, you know, we might see some effects of that because he's a good player. But they have a real gifted quarterback, but Prescott's going to just have to focus mentally and do what you're supposed to do, and I think everything will work out. And this is a tough conference, and you really need to get a good step in getting a win that first game.
Prescott Curley Wolves faced their two toughest rivalries the last 2 weeks and came up on the bad end of those two ball games. But tonight they start the conference play, which what really matters. We'll be back after this with our opening kickoff.
Curley Wolf football is a presentation of the Bank of Prescott, Holly's Health Mart, Medical Park Hospital, Napa Auto Parts and Supply, and Taylor's Big Star Grocery.
Congratulations to the Scrappers for winning the game and winning the bet with the Hope Bobcats.
Nick Lemons and Terry Woodley.
Be nice if this would start like last one did.
Right,
in our favor this time.
Kick is away. It's a squib kick taken by Hopper right at the 20. He'll pick it up. He's got a little bit of room right up in the middle. He's still on his feet. We'll get out to almost the 40-yard line.
Good effort. Good field position to start your opening drive. Kicker didn't get a good foot on that one, so Prescott just needs to come out and do what they can do to get the field position in their favor and maybe get on the board first.
First and 10 from their own 39. Matthew Yates in at center, along with looks like Hobson and Woodley on the right side. And ball handed off to Woodley left side and not anywhere to go.
Lost about two on that play. Rail. Bismarck had it well read. Prescott's crowd a little slow in getting here, but
that was Ryan Perdue on the right side, right guard there. I picked up the wrong number. Loss of about one.
Three quarters full in the stands and people still getting here. So nice crowd. Prescott's second home game of the year.
Second down and 11. Two receivers split to the right. Bullock hands the ball to Woodley right side. He's got a little room this time. Nice tackle there by number 78 to trip him up for the Lions, Charlie Morris.
Tell you what, he just got a hold of a little bit of an ankle there. Terry would have had quite a few more yards on that. Just made a good run, ran through a couple tackles back in about the line of scrimmage.
Ball placed on the 44-yard line.
Prescott, another third and about long five, maybe six. And can still run effectively out of this set. They have a safety back about 50 yards deep, and it's just third down, but I don't know what.
Bullock drops back to pass, getting a little pressure from the backside, and hit as he throws. Calvin Flemings will cover it, and they got a penalty flag down.
That's probably in the area of holding, too, Jim. But Josh set up and planted to throw then, but he just didn't get any help on that backside and took a pretty good lick in the back, and they did call an incomplete pass. His arm was moving forward. They're discussing it with Bismarck, so it's probably holding or clipping in that area, and they'll most likely decline that.
Penalty decline, that'll make it fourth down for the Curley Wolves. Ball on the 44-yard line, so.
That was a very unique defense, though, putting your safety back
right
that far in the defensive backfield.
Keeps you from getting beat.
Well, he looked, you know, he gave you the idea he was going back to return a punt, but I guess that's the reason for it.
Special teams have been a big struggle for Prescott so far this year, and they do get the punt away, a good high punt. Fair catch taken on the 25.
And they're not throwing a flag, but I've when you make the motion to fair catch and take off with it, that should have
maybe been a penalty, but I think he realized what he had done. But the referees were probably made the right call. I mean, he didn't take off very aggressively there.
Bismarck will take over on their own 20, just outside their own 24-yard line.
Keon Sockwell back this week. He's missed the last couple games with a leg injury.
Split one receiver out to the right. Myers hands off to the fullback.
Pretty good stop there. That was Sockwell with Fred Hobson. This offense is a very tricky offense maybe to play, especially early in the game. They do a lot of movement. They do throw the ball a lot. 700 yards in three games. That's pretty good average, though, that most people would be happy to have.
Bring up a second down and eight. Randy Davis gained 2 yards on the carry.
Really have to get some penetration from your middle people, though. I mean, like this set here.
Four receivers out to the right. One comes in motion. Myers drops back. He's hit. It's a lateral. Good job that time to get it. A big loss there. Terry Woodley.
Pretty risky play. Somebody looked to have bumped the quarterback about the time he let the ball go, and that's what I was kind of getting to a while ago, is I think that's where your defense is going to shine if you get that push up the middle. You know, that just disrupts a whole lot of things you want to do.
That'll put the ball back on the 22-yard line, third down and 12. Well, excuse me, that's back to the 17-yard line. Myers looking deep, has a man open, first down Lions.
Boy, that was a nice catch and nice. He really held the ball on his hip well. And tell you what, that was just a good pass route. You know, that was a guy coming from the far side that just dragged across the middle of the field and made a real nice catch. He kind of got behind his defender and a little better throw on the money a little more.
Yeah.
Would probably have had quite a few more yards on that play.
First and 10 Lions from their own 43-yard line. 26 yards pass completion from Myers to Hartsell. Myers hands the ball off.
Got a penalty flag on the top of the screen there, and I don't know if – I didn't see any jumping unless it was maybe a legal motion. Prescott kind of let the field position get back in Bismarck's favor, you know, on that long pass completion. I think that was a legal shift, maybe two men moving at the same time that you cannot do.
That'll back him up 5 yards.
From people I've talked to, Bismarck's pretty physical. You know, they're going to be a team that maybe a lot of teams in this conference have overlooked a few
in the past,
but I don't know this year that might be the case. They have decent size and look like they have good skill people.
First down, 15. Myers on the option, pitches the ball to Hartsell, and Curly Wolves converge and stop him for no gain.
But that's the way you want to go the football there. That we had about 8 men over there, and basically there's just no place for him to go. So there again, we're getting them in long situations. We just have to, you know, keep that constant pressure on their quarterback. Kind of a muggy night tonight. It's not quite as cool as it has been, so conditioning. You know, Bismarck small in number.
They're not very deep. They've got a good starting lineup, but they're not as deep as.
And that's kind of like, Prescott's
right.
A lot that way, you know, so far this year, too.
And we got a delay of game. That'll back them up 5 more.
So they're making some foolish mental penalties, you know, like, you know, Prescott had their share last week that I know that they want to really improve on that aspect of their football. I mean, that's a lot of football. It's just the middle things.
And when you're backing yourself up on penalties and that field position can get turned on you in a hurry, they've lost, you know, 10 yards so far on this drive due to penalties.
Really, probably look for this young man to come out throwing here in a minute. I mean, he showed that he had a pretty nice little arm there a while ago.
It's going to bring up a second down and about 20. Myers drops back. Oh, and they tried a little slip draw that time to Hartzell, and there's Marlow to stop it.
Pretty well played there. He gained about maybe 3 yards. And
little Statue of Liberty play. They did that a few times before.
Raphael stayed at home there at the linebacker and didn't really bite on that too much there. You could kind of, well, from up here, you could see that one setting up pretty well.
I remember a couple of years ago they ran that play quite a bit. It's third down.
So we let them get out of this same situation a while ago.
Myers drops back to pass, has time, has a man open, incomplete.
And it was a good call. I was watching. He had his hand in there, and that will give him automatic first down. And it, you know, as good a defender as Edward can be, he just got kind of, the guy kind of broke to the inside and kind of got him twisted around. And sometimes a penalty is better than giving up something bigger than that. But that's two big plays that Bismarck has converted and on long down situations. And they're doing what they need to do. They're coming out of their own end of the field.
That's a 15-yard penalty, but it will give them the first down. So they'll have the ball at the 49-yard line. First down. Getting ready to cross over into the Prescott field. Into the field.
Yeah, that play there, our end kind of got kind of suckered down into the inside, and that just gave the quarterback a lot of time to throw.
First and 10. Myers drops back to pass. There's Calvin Flemings, and ball's loose. Prescott picks it up. Fred Hopton picks it up. And,
oh, man.
I guess they're going to call that a shovel pass.
It looked like a
I guess that would, I'm not so sure, but if I believe that's the correct call, it's going to be an incomplete pass. They made that rule a few years ago about the shovel pass, you know, being a legal pass.
Boy. They're talking to the captains of both teams, and you're correct in saying, I mean, he did make the motion to shovel it forward, but that could almost, you know, if you really thought about it, being a legal grounding too, because right. There wasn't even nobody around there. But
here's the thing that could be going on is if they're going to mark the ball right there, it's a turnover. Because you can't throw the ball there. I mean, you can't mark it there.
He's motioned again. I don't really know exactly
how
what,
can you mark
what,
the ball there?
If it was an incomplete pass, it should be second and 10 and not first and 15.
Exactly.
And they're still discussing. And Bismarck hurriedly gets to the line of scrimmage. Yeah. I don't blame him.
Now, if they mark it there, it's the correct call.
Which I agree with. I think you might could have called that one incomplete pass, now, even though I do think.
If that's what they call, like I said, if it was a fumble, then that's something different. But I believe that was an incomplete pass.
Referee,
I will give him the benefit of the doubt on that one.
Referee is talking to our coaching staff to kind of
straighten everything.
Still trying to maybe straighten out exactly what went on there. I'm not sure they're biting on it right now, but.
Well, this will give you a chance to. we've had some tough breaks this year on things going in our favor in several instances, but that's part of the game. I mean, you know, that the referees are out there; they're part of the game just like anything else, and you've got to overcome those things one way or another.
Well,
second down and 10.
In all fairness to them, you know, I do some high school officiating.
Should be second down.
You're gonna make your mistakes, and I don't know that that was one.
Myers, quick drop, incomplete pass.
And it should be third down.
Yeah,
now.
I think they got it changed and right before the ball was snapped. So
okay, now we're all straight. But as I was getting to a while ago, I mean, I really don't necessarily think they made a bad call there. I think that probably was the right call. But you're going to make mistakes, just
exactly.
Like the players do. I mean, I've made plenty.
Oh,
I'm sure you could ask a lot of people. You know,
seen you umpire.
But that's, you know, that's you have a lot that don't. So, you know, it's just how it goes. But it should be third down, and they do have second down on the scoreboard and the yard markers.
Myers on the option. He's hit by Sockwell over there, but the ball's loose this time, and Prescott will recover, and it will be our ball this time.
I'll tell you what, they said they were pretty physical. Prescott's throwing some pretty good licks out there themselves.
So we have our first turnover of the game, and it goes in Prescott's favor.
I didn't see who made the hit on that far side, but looked like maybe a helmet went in there and just kind of jarred
it. I think it may have been Ralph Marlowe and Fred Hobson over there and Calvin Flemings as well. I think all three of them were in the vicinity.
So Prescott basically back where they started at to begin the game, and their safety still back about 35 yards.
First and 10 Prescott from their own 44. Woodley coming in around the right side looking for room. He's got some room. He cuts it up now. He's got out to about the 41-yard line, it looks like, where they're going to mark it.
That was a pretty good job of running right there. He really used his blockers well. That play was really looked like to be maybe stopped for negative yards even, and Terry just was patient.
Joy Wyman did a good job of coming back and picking up a blocker or picking up a defender and making a good block.
He showed real good patience as a runner right there, and then that's not something that's easy to do. I mean, when you're in a heated game wanting to go,
right,
you know, to have that patience to do that.
14-yard gain. First and 10. Bullock again gives to Woodley. Hit right at the line of scrimmage, and there's a flag.
That might have been a face mask, Jim. I have not noticed the indication yet. That's either that or a hold. It's right in that same area. But it's
holding.
Going against Prescott. Oh. You know, it's one of them plays that, you know, me and a friend of mine were talking about that. You know, you probably could call holding every play, but it's just the obvious ones I think the officials will call.
Right.
I mean, if you really reach out and grab a hold of somebody like that, you have to do it. But I don't know if they're legal ways, but there are ways to get away with that you won't get called for it. And,
well, there's legal ways to hold. I mean, you can hold as long as you keep your hands inside. First down and 20. Third receivers to the left. Bullock drops back to pass,
and
there's the pressure, and there, I mean, not a soul touched him over there.
And we're back into that. We got somebody going at it hard downfield here.
Back to the
Kendall Todd downfield. I mean, that's what you want.
Right.
I like to see one of our linemen get aggressive and go after somebody, you know, as long as it's legal and you know, football's a physical game, you know, pop somebody in the face mask. But Josh there again, I mean, he didn't even really get time to get back and set up at all.
That's a minus 12 on that particular play. Backs Prescott back up to their 35-yard line.
And their defense is moving the ball about as good as their offense
did
at the time.
Prescott's had one first down so far tonight.
And better hurry to get this play off.
Bullock drops back to pass, quick pass, and it's dropped.
Well, it looked like you had two people in the same spot there, and I don't think that was probably intended to do that. But we're going to have to depend on Brad to get a good foot on this punt.
Still third down. We still got one more down to get some of it back.
Looking at the scoreboard, they had four, so that middle screen, you know, that seems to be a play, but you have to like the idea of their safety back. It still leaves the middle of the field wide open,
right,
you know, in front of him. And they're sending.
Oh, man. Josh is hit. He's going to get away. He's still loose, trying to find somebody to throw it to, and he's just going to throw it up. It's going to be picked off and then dropped.
It wasn't ever caught.
Oh, that should have been an incomplete pass, I think.
Well, I don't know. It was. Boy, Sidney Lake.
He hit him hard. But
there again, I mean, Josh.
Just threw it up.
No, but he gave it such an effort.
Hey,
there just wasn't any blocking. I mean, it's just.
you got to have time.
You know, I want to be as positive, and I'm for these kids 100%. But, you know, there's hundreds of people here, and you know, I'm, nobody wants to just – but you got to block. I mean, there's –
That's right.
I mean, he did a good job just to even get a pass off, period.
You've got to put a hat on somebody and knock them the other direction. Myers hands the ball off to Hartzell, and he breaks one tackle. He's still on his feet, dragging a defender.
Sit. Yeah, Woodley, pretty sure tackler. He got a bind that time, Terry. Just didn't normally very sure-handed on that open field tackle, but good. That's something that Bismarck, I'm sure, would love to do is get that second and 1-2 yards to go.
Bring up a second down and about two. Send four receivers over to the right. Spread the defense out a whole lot. Myers drops back. Has time. Throws it up.
Oh, boy.
And good defense there by
Hey, what, that's a risky
Mark
pass. I tell you what. Gabe Mormon, my hat is off to him that time. Gabe did what I've been wanting somebody to do for three games. He lowered his head, and the center went straight to the ground on his backside. And it just get aggressive. And he did a good job then. I mean, he knocked the kid straight back on his back and made him throw it a little quick. Risky pass.
That is.
That high pass to the outside out there is a very, very dangerous pass to throw.
But Mark Jones had good coverage over on that right side. Three receivers to the right, two to the left. No question what they're going to do here. Myers drops back, short drop, and boy, good catch.
He got a first down.
Mark Jones delivered a lick.
Boy, but, you know, not a very big receiver, but he got the job.
He's 5'5".
That was a nice pass, too. I mean, it was crisp and right on the money there.
They gained about 3 yards, which is what they needed to get the first down.
That receiver probably kind of like, could you not lead me right into that again? I mean, I appreciate the ball being thrown to me, but hey, they converted, and that's what it basically boils down to.
First down from the Prescott 38. Bismarck has a nice little drive going here after the turnover. Fullback right up to Mendel. And there's
flag this time. I think we're fisting to get them for holding just like. I think it's the same thing we just got on us a while ago. They're going to get a hold. A good run, good effort from their
face mask.
Well, I was wrong as usual again. But that was. Tell you what, boy, they've.
So they gained
another first down. No, that's going to.
So they gained about 5 yards, and then or 6 yards, and they're going to pick up 15 more probably on the
field. Or maybe five, you know.
Let's see where they go with it.
It's just a five, but that will give them the first down. So, boy, they're down on the Prescott 26-yard line with 2:50 left in the first quarter.
Still don't have a score yet, but, boy, Bismarck is really getting close. We've exchanged turnovers, and now the Myers, and there's a flag.
That looked maybe like motion there, Jim. It was maybe looked like maybe on this left side that somebody got a little bit quick before the snap.
And
that was what it was. Both teams making their share of penalties right now.
It's sure making this game a lot longer than it would normally go.
Oh, I kind of thought this one would probably be a long one, and it's setting up to be just that.
First and 15 for the Lions. No score. 2:37 to go in the first quarter. Four receivers go to the right. Myers drops back to pass, looking to the left side. And Glenn just had it go through his hands.
Good coverage there. He made sure he didn't get behind him there. Didn't get a real good release on that pass as he has earlier in the game. That one kind of looked like it came out a little loose out of his hand.
So that'll bring up a second down and 15.
Bismarck, their defense really resembles Prescott's in a lot of the ways that they blitz about every down. is what they look like, and we haven't been able to pick it up at all, and they're picking ours up a little bit, but we've put some pressure.
Myers drops back to pass again, and he throws it intercepted by Mark Jones.
Oh, boy.
Good job. Another good, turnover.
Good catch, boy. I was hoping Mark was fitting to pop to the outside there, but he almost dropped it, but he regained it enough to. So Mark's playing a good, you know, made a couple pretty big hits and might have been the one that jarred that fumble loose earlier. I don't know for sure, but
he's played a good game each week, I think, in that defensive secondary to really – and they're going to have to play well tonight because they're going to be tested.
Yeah, Bismarck has shown they can move the football, but I feel like we're going to be able to move the ball too here.
First and 10, Curly Wolves on their own 33. 2:13 to go, first quarter, no score. Bullock hands the ball off to Hobson right up the middle. Good game.
Yeah, Fred's pretty basic in the way he runs the ball. I mean, it's straight and it's hard right at you. And
he covers it up
Not a lot of juking going on. It's just
gain of about five.
And I tell you what, out of that set, and I'm sure before we're out of here tonight, we'll see it. But, boy, you've really got Bismarck jumbled up inside. Spread out a little more now. But, boy, they were all inside the tackles there. A lot of room in the middle of the field.
Second down, six. Bullock pitches the ball. Oh, what a block Giles put on. And Marlowe just ran past the defender.
Well, Fred, I don't
know.
I maybe fought Fred a little bit
on that
because Ralph was kind of thinking maybe Fred was there again. Fred, I'm trying to run over somebody here, but Ralph, I think, thought Fred was to his outside shoulder, and boy, that I think Sidney Giles
man did had a
crackback block,
and the boy is wobbling off the field.
That just got his bell rung real well on this left end. Very legal. I mean, he hit him right square in the face mask.
Gain of about three. That'll bring up a third down and three.
But that play had big, you know, Fred
should've
just a hard
outside.
Runner. But if he'd have stayed it outside, it had potential to have some big yards.
I believe you are correct on that. Ball handed off to Hobson over the left side.
Good.
He carries a pile, I believe, far enough for the first down.
And that was just what I was maybe discussing a while ago. He just put his head down and really basically didn't have anything there, but he just made it happen with just good hard running.
Prescott has a lot of good backs, and it's really pretty hard to get all of them involved.
Yeah, Fred, as you say that, Fred comes out to get a break because he is our kind of our anchor on defense,
right.
I guess you would say. So Woodley's back in.
Joseph in at fullback. First and 10, Bullock hands the ball to Woodley. He sidesteps the tackle, still on his feet, spinning. And he gained a yard, but it was a hard yard.
That was
maybe two.
Very hard yard. That's probably going to be the last play of the first quarter. Is have about 15 seconds left in the first quarter, and we won't get another playoff.
That'll end the first quarter with our score 0-0. We'll be back right after this. Second down and eight.
Ball's snap wasn't handled there. Had a little trouble with that last week, you know. Half a dozen or so times of just not getting the snap, and that just, I mean, luckily we did keep possession of it, but that sets up a long third and 10 situation. And I really don't, Prescott hasn't shown that they're real comfortable in that position yet.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess nobody really is, but, you know, if you're a little more pass-oriented, it doesn't bother you as bad.
Third down and nine. Bullock, little short drop there. Sockwell open. Excellent little play.
You know, that's what I was getting to earlier, is their safety so far off the ball and their linebackers are jamming up at the line of scrimmage. That was a perfect, good call from our coaches there, you know, to recognize that because it was I like the way Keon, you know, washed the ball into his hands. I mean, their safety, I guess that keeps them from breaking it on you, but there's a lot of room there. He's even farther back now than he was.
Prescott have it on the Bismarck 37-yard line, first down, and the ball is loose, and I think Hobson got back on it. Not a clean handoff that time.
It looked like Josh didn't get there that time to get it to him. I'm still kind of amazed, and I'm probably going to ask – some of the Bismarck coaches are up here by us. Sometimes they might not appreciate me asking, but I've never really watched a safety be that far off the line of scrimmage, and I hadn't heard them yet.
Yeah. Second down and 15. Ball on the Bismarck 42. Bullock drops back to pass. Pass complete to Glenn. He's got some open room.
Oh,
and that could be six. It will be. Touchdown, Prescott Curly Wolves. 42-yard touchdown pass.
Boy, you talking about juking out of your drawer. That safety. If he was back there for that reason, Edward put a juke and move there that just basically, I don't think he ever got. Good pass from Josh.
That's right.
It was right on the money. And
first time of this year that Prescott has got on the scoreboard first.
Yeah, and if you don't think that don't matter a lot, I tell you, anytime
really
you look up in your head, it gives you that little extra. Marlowe, I believe this first time this year, he's going to be the extra point.
Snaps high. They get it down. Marlowe's going to miss that one. That didn't even make it out of the end zone.
Snap was that Josh had to, all he could do to get it down. But
with 10:24 to go in the half, Prescott leads 6-0. After a 42-yard pass from Josh Bullock to Edward Glenn, and a nice little play there, Gary.
Yeah, it you know, Edward ran a good route, just a pretty simple slant, and the line did a good enough job that you always want to come out low on somebody to make that defender get his hands down, and Josh hit him and made a good run. Heard Mineral Springs up 15-0 on Garden, and, you know, I really thought Mineral Springs might have the better football team, but
Pure Four kicks it away. It's going to be short and go out of bounds.
Just didn't get a good toe on that one there, so that'll give. They have the option to make us re-kick right. Or take it on the. I believe it's the 40.
That's one of the toughest games for Prescott to play is the game against Garden, because it comes right after Hope, which Prescott gets up so high for that Hope ball game.
And Garden more so
right.
Toward us. And boy, you know, I talked to a person from Garden, and, well, matter of fact, there was a guy sitting up in the booth with us the whole game and couldn't believe that Garden was playing that way. And it just seems to happen. And we didn't help ourselves either, don't
right.
Get me wrong.
But Garden played, they did what they had to do to win. Myers drops back to pass. Pass will be complete to Hartzell. He'll be driven out of bounds at about the 40. Well, they're going to mark him right at the 45.
So that was a nice pass right there. That was a well-delivered football. And that's kind of a version of a pick.
Right.
You know, I mean, it's legal if you get away with it. But that inside receiver, he just kind of cuts off that outside man, and he kind of just runs like an interference for him. And
right.
it's a good play if you can execute it the way they did just then.
First and 10, Bismarck from the 45. They really have moved the ball well in between the 30s, but haven't quite been able to do anything to get the ball in the end zone yet. Myers drops back to pass. He's going to be hit as he throws. The ball is overthrown.
And boy, and he had him wide. He had him, but boy, he took a pretty good shot.
Brad got pulled inside, and that's one thing. Your free safety's got to be back there. Can't get inside to let the receivers get behind you.
To our favor, I think if he would have had just another second to throw, though, he would have put that one on the money.
Incomplete pass, and
it's pretty yeah. Aggressive football game right now. Hey,
second down and 10. One receiver to the left, kind of a wing formation with their backs there. Send Hartzell in motion. Myers drops back, hands the ball off to Hartzell, and Sockwell makes a great play. Ball is on the ground.
I think they blew it dead.
He did
call it. Tell you what,
Coach Ben is very
Coach
upset
Bennett
there.
He's been primed up for a little bit, and he is as hot as I've noticed him being in a while. The middle official did not call it, you know, and
yeah.
The guy from the side, but it was close either way.
Third down and 9, ball on the Bismarck 46-yard line.
Sockwell's made a lot of difference. You notice his absence the last two games from injury. He made a good, nice catch and good play there.
And Myers is going to be sacked by Marlowe. Excellent play that time. They went straight for the quarterback.
And they had a little they kind of ran into each other, the fullback and him. And once that happened, it was just all over there. Calvin Flemings will return this punt. I see Calvin come up and catch it. And with Woodley, and they're putting two back. Both of them have that capability of making a big play. Bismarck does a lot of trickery, though. You always really have to be on your toes with what they do.
Mackey back deep to kick it away for the Lions. And they're going to get it away. And there's a flag on the play as well. And Fleming's going to pick it up on the 24. Runs into Woodley. He's trying to find some room, and boy, just nothing there.
He got nailed. I don't know. I think maybe Bismarck might have been moving, and they weren't completely set when the snap was put into play. We'll wait and see. I don't know that Prescott would decline it, though. He didn't get a very good foot on that one.
Let's see what they'll call here. They may make them punt it again and see if we can get a better return out of it. They are going to bring it. Get everybody back out there and have them do it again.
I think they had one too many people out there, Jim, is what maybe the call was there. They have not indicated a signal yet, but I think I counted maybe one more than you're supposed to have. Prescott's going. We're fishing to go for it. Right? Prescott's going for the block right here. He's got everybody up, but Brad Harris back deep, so he must have noticed something on that last one. We're fixing to make an effort to go after this.
Greggy is waiting the punt. It's a high snap, and they're going to get to him. And the ball is loose. Prescott will get the ball inside the 30-yard line.
So it worked. That pressure, it got just a high enough snap that he wasn't. I don't think he could have got it off, though. I think he was wise to try to get out of there because he got a Bismarck player down on the field.
We'll have a break here in the action with 8:33 to go in the first half. Prescott leads 6-0. 10 from the Bismarck 28-yard line. Prescott is leading 6-0 with 8:33 to go in the first half. Bullock hands the ball off to Hobson over the right side. He's got room if he breaks out. And there he's still on his feet, but
boy,
good run.
That's good effort. Good effort. Needed about one or two more people to put a hat on somebody to help him out a little bit, but he gained 7 and ran about 40. He gave it as he always does. Fred's gonna give you all he's got. Prescott doing a good job of getting their plays in and out. You know, notice they're a little crisper getting them.
Second down and 4. Bullock drops back to pass, and he didn't have anybody that time. He's going to tuck it under and run, and I think that was a good decision.
Yeah,
the receiver was covered that time.
You know, don't try to make something happen that's not there, because sometimes it'll work in your favor, but more times than not, it's going to be something that won't be good for your football team. And Bismarck just had that one play good. You can see the receiver. He was covered up, and there wasn't any need in forcing anything.
Third down in about 3.
2 down area right here, but hope you don't get to that point.
They've got it really bunched up this time all across the line. Bullock hands the ball off to Woodley right up the middle, and he's going to break it right around the end. Touchdown, Curly Wolves, 21 yards.
Ran right behind Mormon and Gully and Yates at center, and
they blew off the football that time.
He had just a very – Terry's is very good at just a slight hesitation of watching where that hole forms, and he hit it. We'll go for 2 here to try to get it back to 14.
And this is the way Prescott really has played throughout the year so
They're
far.
They're playing more to their capabilities, and they just
had a lot of mental mistakes last week with offsides and things like that really hurt you, and you don't realize how important they are until you see the outcome of how it affects you. Bullock will drop back to pass, and he went the wrong way, or the backs did one. I think he did, because everybody was this direction. But that's all right. Got 7:03 to go in the first half. Prescott leads 12-0. Till the half, Prescott has been able to capitalize on some mistakes that Bismarck has made tonight, which has really been something that Prescott hadn't had the luxury of very much. We were able to do it last week right before the end of the half and looked to have control of the game as we started in that third quarter, and it kind of fell apart on us. First and 10, Curly Wolves. Ball on the Bismarck 41. Prescott leading 12-0. Josh drops back to pass, and it's going to be picked off this time. Good interception that time. He stepped right in on the play.
He read that one all the way of where Josh was. You know, you don't want to just zero right in on where you're going. And, I mean, threw a nice ball, but it just was a good defensive play, and he just made a good aggressive defensive play.
Yeah, I just was saying how much we were able to handle the ball well tonight, and we make a turnover there.
Bismarck hurriedly up, you know, trying to get something going.
Myers going to be handing off right that time. I missed that one completely.
Good open field tackle there from Edward Glenn. You know, still nice, about an 8-yard gain.
Looked that like that was Laliberti on the carry.
A little trap that got a few of us confused to where the ball was going.
Out to the 41-yard line, gain of almost 8.
Got a very good National Scrapper team coming over to Prescott next week. That's always a lot of crowd at that one, you know,
right.
real good rivalry there.
Myers hands the ball off to Mackey.
First down.
Nope. That was Davis, excuse me, but it was a first down.
You know, Bismarck's passing game, we've kind of disrupted it a little bit, and they're going back to, you know, two good runs there that converted a first down for them. And high school football, you get first downs, that clock will, you have a lot of time to do what you need to do.
First down Lions on their own 46. 3:50 to go in the first half, Prescott leading 12-0. Myers gives the ball to Davis again.
Came long two.
And the Lions look like they have another player down on the field.
Little slack in number to begin with.
And I don't know if he's going to get up quickly or if it's going to be a minute. Looks like he's getting up already, so we'll hold it here and
.328 left in the first half.
Looks like he may be down for a moment. Well, .328 to go in the first half. Prescott leads 12-0. And bring up a second down and about 8 from their own 48-yard line. Number 21 that time, Coy Hasley. A little slow getting up. Couldn't really tell if he was limping or anything, but they can't afford to have too many injuries.
Now that's two or three that's went out with a little banged up. One guy just got knocked around pretty good. We'll keep it here. Bismarck will use a timeout. You know, talking about the upcoming conference schedule, you know, Prescott going to have all they possibly could want next week with a good, you know, top-rated 3A team in the state, Nashville, coming over, and I know they'll bring a gob of people. They have some of the better fans you'll find. They really do. I mean, they, you know, when Prescott and Nashville had their big wars several years back where we beat them over at Little Rock, and then the next year they beat us over there, those were two of the best high school football games you could, you know, want to see. You know, even though it was about 10 below zero that one game, it was warmer on our side that day. But,
right.
But they did get us back the next year. That was when, you know, McBride and Washington were just breaking all kind of records. And, I mean, as big a Prescott fan as I am, I appreciated the skill those two young men had. And that whole team, I mean, they were a good football team. I've watched them against Ashdown a few times, and they're going to be, you know, they're going to be a hard team to beat for Prescott. But I know Prescott will give it a good effort. We're pretty tough at our home place, you know, usually year in, year out. So,
and another thing, you know, you with it being a conference game, this is such a tough conference. You have to stay on top of things. There's every week you've got to be ready to play because it's a tough conference. Hartzell hands the ball off to the fullback.
Good play there. And I had my eye on who made it, and then it got quite a pile going there. I think that's Fred Hobson that made that play at that and middle linebacker
Moorman's at the
spot.
Bottom of that pile again as well, and he's done a fine job tonight.
We will try to get a player of the week again. Last week over at Garden, it was just kind of impossible for us to do that with the crowd situation, getting down there to do that. But we will try to do that again this week.
Looking at about a third down and six. Hartzell is in at quarterback right now. He drops back to pass, and he throws one. It's complete. No, it's incomplete, they said.
That'll get them in a fourth down situation. They don't show any signs of kicking it away right here. So,
and with the ball in the middle of the field, I can understand where they're going for. They played very well so far tonight as far as moving the football. But they do have their kicker is on the field right now back in the punting formation. That's Mackey.
Hopefully. I guess they really don't want to give Prescott the ball around midfield unless, you know, they hadn't necessarily kicked this ball yet either.
No, they hadn't. They're bringing everybody up here. Good snap. Mackey gets away, and boy, Marlow got popped pretty good that time.
But that was a good punt on their behalf. It got Prescott down, you know, about the 22-23-yard line. Yeah, Raphael got freaking.
He got a pretty good shot there,
trying to get through there and block it. But that's, you know, that's just the way some of it goes sometimes.
Prescott will take over on their own 23-yard line.
Don't know if you'll see Prescott come out in their form of their two-minute drill. You know, I feel like they don't have anything to lose in doing that.
Right.
You know, you don't want to make a mistake and give them the ball on right here on this part of the field with that much time left.
2:15 to go in the first half. Prescott is leading 12-0. Bullock drops back to pass. He gets a little pressure, gets away from it, and then, oh, and the ball was there for Glenn, and he just didn't hang on to it.
Somebody just didn't pick up that backside defensive end or corner. I didn't notice who the player was, but he was untouched, and that just he didn't. Josh did a good job to avoid him, but that kind of disrupted the.
He didn't get a chance to set his feet.
The flow of that game. But nice play though. I mean, Prescott. They kicked out well, and that one man just came free. And they're, like I said, they really resemble our team in the fact that they're sending linebackers almost every play.
Three receivers split to the right. Nolan to the left. Bullock drops back to pass. He's going to throw it deep, and Flemings is over there, but it's going to be intercepted by Hartzell and dropped right there.
Yeah, pretty well thrown. They were just really setting back, you know, looking for something long.
There.
I mean, they were pretty well letting you know they weren't going to let nobody behind them. But that's just the way some of that goes. Josh Lyon, give him credit there, though. They did give him time to set and throw, and he set up and threw the ball, you know, with putting his weight, shifting his weight, and put a good arm on that one. Just well defended. 2 minutes exactly.
Bismarck will have it first and 10 on their own 37. Myers back in that quarterback,
motion. Their left guard came out of his stance pretty obviously there, so that'll give Bismarck a 5-yard motion. Now the Prescott cheerleaders doing a good job as always on the track. Bismarck had quite a few 5-yarders against them tonight. You know, some of the same stuff that we ran into last week. Prescott has cut down tremendously on their mental part of their mistakes. You know, had a few, but not very little tonight.
First down and 15. Three receivers go to the right. Myers drops back to pass. He throws it deep. And Glenn was there, and he would have turned around. He would have had it, but
that was good. Good coverage. He didn't bite on anything there. And you know, with this much time left, there's no need. You don't want to let anybody get behind you. No. Well defended there.
He did what he was supposed to do.
Very speedy young man. He can run with probably about anybody on the field, if not faster. So he had a little trouble getting behind him.
Edward, I'm not sure if he scored a touchdown in his high school career before tonight, but he made a good catch and touchdown earlier this evening. Second down and long. Myers drops back to pass.
Oh,
incomplete.
And that, there again, what I spoke of earlier, Gabe Mormon and several more were right back in his face, and that's what disrupts pass play. That's what, you know, has been one of our problems, you know, with some of the things we've tried to do early is the quarterback not getting enough time to throw the ball. So Bismarck will definitely have to, I would think, kick this ball away. It's just third down, though, so I guess they want this play.
Third down and 15. Lions trying to get something going before the end of the half. Three receivers to the right, one to the top of the screen. Myers drops back. They hand off right up the middle.
Good tackle, Fred. Fred just was right there on that. I mean, it looked like it might have set up for a pretty good gainer, but he, as any good linebacker will do, you have to get your reads before you react. You know, go back into pass coverage. Make sure that back doesn't have the ball before you do release, and he did a good job at that.
Ball is placed, looks to be about the 37-yard line. Fourth down.
Prescott's bunching it up, you know, trying maybe going for another punt block.
Mackey back, waiting for the snap. Let the clock run down.
Oh.
He kicked that one off to the left.
Well, he was in such a hurry there, you know, to try to, I mean, good job on his part. Prescott was really putting a lot of pressure upfield there. 57 seconds left till the end of the first half. We'll just have to wait and see if we come out and try to get something going with a minute left. Still have all our timeouts that I'm pretty sure we do. So that's a lot of time, or you can make it be a lot of time.
Prescott is leading 12-0 in the first half. We do have 57 seconds to go, so this is an opportunity for Prescott to either put some more points on the board or just get it run out.
They're going to have to get on up to the line of scrimmage and get this one ran.
Fleming's in at tailback. And they're going to call a timeout.
Just a little lazy there in the huddle, getting in and out of there because they got to play in plenty of time.
We'll have a break in the action. 57 seconds to go in the first half. Prescott leads 12-0.
Hometown owned and operated.
You to go in the half. First down and 10 from their own 39. Bullock drops back to pass. And there's a flag down on the play. Bullock's just going to take it and run out of bounds and get a few yards. They could have called a late hit that time, but they didn't.
No, I think we were in motion to start with on that one. It looked like we moved a little fast. But
I don't know whether they weren't set or whether they didn't have enough on the line. They threw it right as the ball was snapped.
Yeah, it looked like our outside receiver might have moved a little too quick, too, just from, you know, what I could see up here. That might not be exactly who that was on. But nevertheless, Josh, you know, he was trying to get out of bounds, you know, and stop the clock. You still have time to go to the middle of the field, though. I mean, we still have three timeouts, two timeouts. That there again, both teams, you know, we've cut down on the penalties quite a bunch tonight, but still probably more than they want to have.
First down and 15. Receiver split in the backfield. Bullet. And he can't get outside. I tell you,
it's just
too quick. They were quick.
That end on that top side there, just not, you know, Prescott will use one of their two remaining timeouts to try to get something going, but he just didn't have time enough to get outside that one defender there, and that had some people downfield that probably would have been open, it looked like from up here, but very long first half. Both bands getting ready to do their halftime part of the football game.
Very colorful uniforms for the Bismarck Lion Band. They have some, I guess you'd call them the tie-dye colors.
Sounds good to me.
And even their drums have it wrapped around them. It's very colorful from up here.
And I remember their band a few years ago, you know, they seemed like they wore like all tuxedo type
right.
uniform and were very good. And mm-hmm. Prescott's band does a good job. So I, with a daughter in the band, I do pay more attention than I used to, you know, doing this. We sometimes have to keep up with what we're doing up here to keep our record straight. But I do try to take time out to pay close attention to the bands.
And they put in a lot of long hours, too. In the summer, they're up there practicing. And
I will guarantee you they put up a long hour. Yes, very. You know, a lot of hot days on mm-hmm. that asphalt parking lot is, with the summer we had, they deserve to get as much attention as anybody else.
I most definitely agree. Second down and about 24. We have 35 seconds to go in the first half, and Prescott still leading 12-0. I think the last couple of minutes have been 30. Bullock drops back to pass. He steps up, rolls out to his right, has time still on his feet, and not a soul to get it away to.
There just didn't nobody that. There just didn't time, and boy, they are just pouring the pressure to Prescott, and I don't think we're going to worry about, yeah, no Bismarck.
We have 18 seconds to go here in the first half. We'll go ahead and take another break. Prescott leading 12-0.
When you're ready to buy a new car, a truck, a van, or SUV, John Hayes Automotive is your place. Our people are ready to please. We've got great selection, number one service, and prices that are really low. You'll like the way our salesmen treat you, folks you trust and know. So check out our lot, ask about our service, compare our prices today. You'll like what you find in the way that you're treated when you just say John Hayes.
Come see us at I-30 Highway 4 right here in Hope, Arkansas.
Congratulations to the Scrappers for winning the game and winning the bet with the Hope Bobcats. Now McDonald's of Nashville is selling quarter pounders with cheese.
12-0 is third down and about 30.
Yeah, Bismarck, you know, they still have a timeout. You know, if we don't convert here, that they're probably going to try to block a punt or something.
They send Glenn in motion. Bullock hands the ball off to Woodley around the left side.
Oh, one block.
And he's got a lot of room. He'll pick up the first down.
Oh,
the ball is loose. And Bismarck will recover the ball.
That was a good call. A lot of people are not agreeing with it.
The ground calls the fumble.
I don't know. I'm going to lean the other way on that one. I mean, of course, you always want to go with your
right.
team. But I tell you what, that was a good hit. Their safety ran about mm-hmm. 30 yards, and he had a beat. And he made a good play. Woodley made a good run. Got a good block from his outside receiver. But I don't know. I kind of saw that indifferently maybe than you did. But it just looked like it came out of there. Good hit. Very good hit.
Oh, yeah. It was a very good hit. 8 seconds to go in the first half. Two receivers split to the left. Drop back to pass, and he'll
good
be sacked
play.
For a loss, and that'll end the first half.
Rafael Marlowe with that backside pressure.
Prescott leads 12-0 at half. We'll be back right after these messages with our band and halftime entertainment. about the 15-yard line by Mackey. Good tackle there by Glenn. Return out to about the 33-yard line is where they're going to spot it.
Had a few wires kind of getting tangled up here, but we got it all situated. So Bismarck wanting to come out, I'm sure, early and try to establish some momentum this second half to get back in the ball. Well, they're still in the ball game,
oh, yeah,
definitely, but to get some points on the board.
The way they move the ball, we know they can. We know. He'll keep it, and he pitches it right before he's tackled. Smart play that time.
Boy, risky play on his part, but it worked for about 7 yards, maybe even 8.
I didn't see who got the pitch. I'm going to assume that it was Hartzell, but I wasn't able to catch the number. Gain of about 7.
Gabe's really...
We'll make it 8.
I've watched him a lot tonight, and he's getting a good push, though. I mean, he's really firing off the football like you want your people to do.
Second down and 2. Second half just underway. Prescott leading 12-0. They hand the ball off up the middle.
And a flag was late. All kind of folks falling around out there, and I don't know what that flag was.
Davis on the carry.
I don't know if there was a face mask or something. It came from that outside official.
It was a face mask call. They did pick up the first down with the run.
Give them additional 5 yards.
The referee was about ready to mark that off against Bismarck, and that wouldn't have helped him a lot.
Oh, it's going to be a 15-yarder, too. So big opening series for Bismarck to come out, you know, and move with a little help from a face mask, but they're getting the ball down on our end of the field rather quickly.
Bismarck will have it first and 10 on the 43-yard line of Prescott. First and 10. Myers hands the ball off to Mackey. Myers hands off to
very little yardage there. Maybe call it a yard at the most. Both bands did a good job at halftime. Good, both of them had a real good performance.
Davis, the ball carries. Pick up about a yard.
Just going to bring up a second down and 9 for Bismarck.
Kendall Todd getting quite a bit of action lately on the defense.
Ball handed off to Hartzell. A good run there by Hartzell.
Fred saved pretty long run right there. He had cut it back inside and had a lot of running room if he hadn't have been there to stop it. Like I was talking about Kendall Todd, he's getting quite a bit of action the last couple weeks, offensively and defensively, and pretty, not real tall, but he's pretty wide load in there. And
third down and 3. Myers pitches the ball out. It's going to be picked up, but he will not get the first down.
Oh, that's a...
And there's another flag, and I bet you they're going to call face mask again by the way that looked.
That or a late hit or something. It had to go against Prescott from where it was thrown. It
another face mask. That's what it looked like.
Boy, that's going to give them a first down, and I don't know if it's the 5 or 15-yard variety, but it'll still give them a first down. And boy, that's just... I don't really know if you'd put that down as a mental thing. I mean, you just kind of grabbing stuff. I mean, it's the major 15. So boy,
that's down to the Prescott 20-yard line.
That's 30 yards of face mask penalties that Bismarck's got this drive. And tell you what, momentum can change real quickly in a football game. And right now, they've got all of it.
And Bismarck has definitely come out into play in this second half. Myers on the option, pitches the ball out to, I believe that was Laliberti. I'm not really sure how you pronounce his last name.
That works with me. That's kind of an unusual option play, though, the way they run that. It's almost like he waits till he's down and then pitches it. It's very risky, but it It made eight positive yards for them, and
you know,
somebody
one thing
needs to get that penetration going again.
That you can say about Bismarck, they're playing without probably their top running back and middle linebacker tonight in Brawley. Myers hands the ball off to Hartzell, and he's going to be close to a first down.
Yeah, he's right on it. Boy, there's some pretty good legs being passed out there. It needs to be directed more toward the guy with the ball, but
he's going to gain 5 yards for the first down.
So that's going to be supposedly the hardest first down to get is right inside the 10 when you have to go. I mean, it has to be a touchdown. But Prescott's going to have to stand up here and somebody make some penetration and make a negative play.
This is the deepest penetration they have had so far. Hartzell goes in motion. Myers hands the ball off right up the middle to, I believe, Davis that time.
Pretty good play there. Marlowe, Gabe on the bottom of the pile again. That one didn't go for maybe a yard gain or so.
It's going to bring up a second down and goal from the 8.
They've kind of went out of their passing and just have went more to their running game. And 30 yards of penalties is really
what's hurt
Prescott bad this particular drive.
Approaching 8 minutes to go here in the third quarter, and Prescott leading 12-0, but
Bismarck's going to have to speed up to get this playoff.
Myers drops back to pass. Ball is tipped away by Hobson. Excellent job to get a hand in there.
I think that ball might have got in there, too, if he hadn't got his hand up. It was going to be a real close play, but it looked like that ball might have been able that he would have been in the end zone.
Have a timeout here with 7:53 to go in the third quarter. Prescott leading 12-0. Getting back started here for the Lions. They have a third down and goal now from the 8-yard line. And we've heard some scores here of interest in our conference. And Nashville winning and Fordyce and Falk, which is tied, which is a big surprise to me. Myers will drop back. He's going to get pressure from Marlowe. He throws it, and it's going to be dropped. And, boy, good coverage by Mark Jones. But the ball was just overthrown, incomplete.
Good pressure from Ralph on that outside from that linebacker position. He really forced him to throw it just a hair quicker than he wanted to. Nice pass. I mean,
yes.
It was a little high, which I think that was strictly from the pressure.
One thing to remember, this Bismarck team and already one of the games they played earlier this year, they played Lakeside, which we scrimmaged up at the Prep Bowl. Played them to a very good football game.
Should have won the football game. I mean, that they had a pretty comfortable lead in that game, I believe.
Right. Came down the last few minutes of the game. Myers drops back. Oh, he's hit just as he throws it, and that'll be a turnover. Prescott will take over on downs.
So defense, they kind of hurt themselves with penalties, and Bismarck executed, but they didn't break. We need to get the ball, though, and get it out of this hole down here on the end of the field.
You know, they were running the ball so well, they stopped running the ball once they got down inside the 10-yard line. And
yeah, they were. They were kind of using their run to hurt Prescott a little bit there. And I know Prescott's coming out in that passing set.
Three receivers split to the left. This is time you'd like to use your fullback. And Bullock hands off to Joseph. Look right up the middle.
Oh, boy.
And that's what you like to do.
Yeah, one little man away there. And Brian had a nice run, but he was real close to getting a real big run out of it. But I tell you what, that right there takes so much pressure off a lot of people when you can get that 7 and 8 yard
right.
First down. You really can do a lot of different things out of that.
Second down and 3. Bullock hands the ball off. Oh, the ball's on the ground, and I believe Bismarck has come up with it.
Yeah, and it just was
not a good clean handoff.
You know, you got to make a good pocket, and you got to be sure you put it in the pocket, and they just didn't execute, and that was that's a golden opportunity for Bismarck to get on the board. Our defense just had a pretty rough stand there a while ago, and it's asking a lot of them to get the ball back on their own 13, but we can do it if they'll just do what they need to do.
Myers hands the ball off to Hartzell, and boy, Woodley held on to that one. Held on to a leg.
And boy, we were very fortunate not to have a late, maybe on the ground there. I think their coach is about, didn't like that one very well. I don't much blame him. I don't think I would have either. He didn't get a very solid, as he's down, the player's momentum. If he had hit him a little more squarely, he might have got a penalty.
Second down and 11, ball placed on the 14-yard line.
They did try to go back to their run. It was well played out on this side. I think that was Terry Woodley that just he grabbed a hold and hung on to that leg.
Two receivers split to the right. Myers drops back to pass, quick pass. Ball's going to be complete to Hartzell. He gets away from the defender. Touchdown,
they put it
Bismarck.
In. They capitalized off a turnover, and boy, that was a good pass. And that was a good, that was a nice catch, too. He threw it where only he could catch it, and he made a good run after it. And Prescott, they need to not drag around now. I mean, they're still in the lead. You're just going to have to forget about that one and be a little more aware of trying to hang on to the football and execute. Bismarck, that was a nice pass. You got to give a kid credit. It was right on the money.
They're going to go for the extra point here. They're running close down on time. Mackey getting set to kick it. They get a good snap, and it's going to be blocked.
Boy, that wasn't very pretty there. No.
6 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third quarter. Prescott leads 12-6. Bismarck Lions get on the board with 6:10 to go here in the third quarter. Prescott turns the ball over and gives them the ball on the 13-yard line. Two plays later, it's a touchdown pass from Chase Myers of 14 yards to Robbie Hartzell to make the score 12-6. Prescott still with the lead.
And the turnovers, boy, they'll do it to you every time.
That's how Prescott got one of their touchdowns, was after the punt wasn't really blocked, but they sacked him, off a bad snap.
We could help ourselves out a lot here with some good field position and should get some here.
Ball's going to be picked up by Glenn on about the 22-yard line. He's got a wall over to this side. If he can just get it around the corner, he's got the corner. Now he's got the sideline. One man to beat. He's still on his feet, and he'll get down to the 30-yard line.
Boy, that set up pretty on this right side, and he did a good job to get there, too.
48-yard kickoff return that time.
Edwards, he's played a good ball game tonight. He got a good line of blocking out here on this right side. So that there again, momentum can really change in a hurry if we can put it in our favor and do something with the field position.
Hobson in now at tailback. Slot right set. Bullock gives the ball to Hobson.
Oh,
maybe get maybe a yard.
Pretty good play from their interior there, though. That was a good shot. You don't see Fred stop pretty much straight at the line of scrimmage very seldom.
Bring up about a second down and 9.
Well, that is as closely bunched as they are. That particular play there really sets that play action up. But they're sending, you really got to pick up their ends, because that's where all their pressure is coming from, is not necessarily up the middle, but on the end.
They're going to call a timeout here. Couldn't quite get everybody set the way they wanted. We have 5:19 to go here in the third quarter. We'll take a break. Prescott leading 12-6. Prescott still leading 12-6 and threatening to score again after a big kickoff return by Ed Glenn. Bullock hands the ball off to Hobson. He's got room over the right side. He'll have the first down inside the 20. And he's still on his feet down to about the 11.
Good hard run there by Fred. He did a little better job there of going with his blocks and just finally lowering his shoulder and getting some very nice gain down to about the 12-yard line.
Nice play coming out of the timeout to get yourself, kind of get everybody set and knowing exactly what you want to do. First and 10. Wolves on the Bismarck 12-yard line. Giles to the left, Nolan to the right. Bullock hands the ball off to Hobson again, right over the left side.
About five yards on that play. Nothing real fancy there. Just line up and try to move some people out of there. Good job, Gully and Mormon on that left side to get. He didn't maybe call it 4 yards on the play.
They're going to mark it on right on the in between the 9 and the 8. So have a second down at about 7. Bullock gives the ball to Hobson. He tries to bounce out to the right. He's still on his feet inside the 5. And he'll get down to about the 2.
That should be right at a first down, too. And, boy, that's just a lot of good effort there. He got hit 5 or 6 times by different people and just kept good determination. But he's still a little short. He third down and call it a long one. I don't really think there's a question of two down tie. I don't think Prescott will even think about kicking if they don't make it. They're going to try to score.
Third down and 1. Slot right set. Bullock gives the ball to Hobson into the end zone. Touchdown.
Touchdown. Good blocking there, too. Fred barely got a hand laid on him. That was right off. Kendall Todd, I was speaking about earlier, right behind him, Matthew Yates, Brian Woodley just did a good job of opening a hole. Fred was looking for contact there, and it just was very little there. That good job of blocking. We'll go for 2.
Really be nice to see him convert this. It would put a lot of pressure then on the Bismarck offense. Bullock drops back to pass. Quick pass. Incomplete.
It was just deflected.
3:44 to go in the third quarter. Prescott leading 18-6.
At Beverly Healthcare of Prescott, our staff of trained professionals are dedicated to providing personalized quality care to meet the needs of our community. We offer a wide range of rehabilitation and nursing services to our patients and residents. Plus, we feature added benefits such as resident transportation. At Beverly, our goal is to make you feel right at home. So whether you need short-term therapy or long-term extended care, Beverly is there for you. We are people who care about people. Beverly Health and Rehabilitation of Prescott. Why is everyone going to Mine Creek Jewelry in Nashville? Maybe it's because it's Mine Creek's 25th anniversary celebration. For 25 days, starting September 1st, Mine Creek is offering you its lowest prices yet, plus a chance to win a $25 silver gift certificate each day, a diamond ring, and other great prizes. Hurry in now for 60% off Mine Creek's large selection of silver jewelry and charms, 50, 60, or even 70% off beautiful gold and elegant diamond jewelry. And you can take 1/3 off Mine Creek's already low prices on Seiko and Citizens watches. Christmas layaway is available on any purchase, including our lowest closeout sale prices, so shop today and save on a very special Christmas gift. Don't miss the 25th anniversary celebration at Mine Creek Jewelry in downtown Nashville, serving you since 1974.
Mine Creek has lots of jewelry. Mine Creek has prices impossible to beat.
That was a big momentum. That kickoff return really changed momentum back to Prescott's favor.
Because they definitely, the Lions had the momentum getting in there and scoring after Prescott turned the ball over, and good to see them bounce back right away. Pure Ford gets a good foot into it. Ball's going to be taken on about the 18-yard line by Hartzell. Giles just misses him, but there's help by Glenn.
Good play by Sidney, though. He really disrupted the whole return they were trying to do. Really, you like to see somebody really fly down the field like that. Sidney's made some pretty good hits for Prescott this year.
All right. Well, a 6-yard kickoff return is pretty good by any standards.
Yeah, well, it was a nice kick. It just kind of fell in between the people, and hard to handle those kind.
First and 10 Lions. Twin set to the right, split backs in the backfield. Myers drops back, quick step, and the ball just dropped.
And I tell you what, that whole play might have been from that last completion he did catch when Mark Jones, I think, was the one that made a big hit on him. You don't really forget those things.
No.
And that hit him right square in the numbers. But.
And that guy's little. He's about 5'5", and I think he was thinking about that last time
yeah,
he caught one.
He's not very big, but it, you know, good pass from the quarterback, though. I mean, it was right on the money.
Second down and 10. Myers hands the ball to Hartzell. Sockwell gets a hand on him. Good job that time by Glenn to turn him back in.
Yeah, just pretty good run, though. He just kind of kept coming off his blockers and ended up picking up about 8 yards on the play. I don't know that Bismarck, that seems to be working better than anything, is that running game. Of course, they did score on a nice pass earlier.
Third down and 2. This is an opportunity Prescott can make a stop here. It really helped their chances to get the ball back in. Myers makes a good, a little bit of a high pass. Mark Jones right there on the coverage.
And Bismarck, boy, they're in a situation here where they almost have to punt it out. You know, being on their own 32 or 33-yard line.
Still a whole quarter to play.
You really don't want to do anything. I mean, you're still in the ball game with with this much time left. There's...
The punter is bringing in the play, so you never know what kind of set they're going to go with.
It looks like they're going for it, Jim. So
fourth down and 2.
Might try to get us to jump, you know.
Moved.
I believe that'll be a dead ball, though, and they'll have to surely line up and punt it now, but their guys got a little bit in too big a hurry. Prescott, good job that time. Last week we got caught in that situation some and jumped, and it really will hurt you. And they were disciplined that time and didn't make any mistakes. And I thought that all along was what Bismarck was going to try to do.
Right. Fourth down and about 7.
Prescott's crowding the line of scrimmage pretty good again.
Ball is kicked straight up. And it's going to be a minus 2-yard punt.
Yeah, the punter's back here wanting roughing, but that wasn't roughing.
No.
I mean, he might have hurt his toe or something, but I don't that was not what you would call roughing. It was just a really hurried punt that he was fortunate to get off and didn't get it off very well.
It's going to be a 1st and 10 Prescott as they take the ball over on the Bismarck 26-yard line. Excellent field position here. Prescott needs to capitalize. Bullock pitches the ball to Woodley over to the right side, looking for a little room to get up the field, and he's still on his feet. And if he can just get away now, he's got open field to the left side.
Score too.
That'll be a touchdown.
No,
and Josh Bullock got called for a penalty.
Josh, is as much as you want to see your quarterback block, but he did. He was. I'm sitting. I watched it when it happened, and boy, Woodley made it.
And I thought it was a good block. I don't know if he got him from behind. I didn't see it.
I watched when the referee threw it, you know, and it looked to probably be a clip. But Woodley made.
But I like to see the effort out there. That's what's really been the positive thing, is that he's out there trying to make something happen for his team.
That's what I mean. You can't, you know, you're falling on the ground trying to block for your teammates. And
Woodley made an excellent run. I mean, an excellent run. I hate to see it being brought back because of the penalty.
But it was a good call. You know, I was sitting there watching it, and it wasn't a very big flagrant, but still, it was behind him, and that's what they're looking at. Good run by Woodley, though. Good job of everybody staying with everything.
It'll still be 1st down. Prescott will have it on the Bismarck 24-yard line. Bullock gives the ball to Hobson that time, right down to about the 20.
Just a hair from popping another one there. Our lines seem to have come into their own a little bit more so than they have the 3 prior games. I think that, you know, they
I think they played well against Hope and against Mineral Springs. They just had a lack of intensity last week.
Right.
But tonight they've really shown a good line. Second down and about four. Bullock. And there's a penalty flag.
Didn't see anything that time, but it will go against Prescott.
That'll back him up. Offside. That's
now that there. There's another one of the thinking things there. You know, you don't want to get back in the habit of that. But just and Coach Bennett is letting somebody know that they shouldn't get in that habit, which he has every right to do.
He'll bring up a second down and eight from the 25. Bullock. Dropping back to pass, and he's not going to get away. It's a 10-yard loss back to the 35.
Good call from their defense. And I tell you what, Prescott's going to see that from now till the end of the season.
That's right.
Unless they start picking that up, because that's really been something that's really hurt them. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's Josh executes it okay, but they're just not getting that guy kicked outside
right.
to give him time to throw the ball.
Third down and about 19. 1 minute to go here in the third quarter. Prescott leading 18-6. Pass is complete to Sockwell, and he fell down on the 20. Oh, just lost his footing. Good pass that time.
Yeah, he lofted it. If he would have tried to throw that one with some speed, it wouldn't have got in there. He just kind of lofted it over the – and that's what I said earlier, that safety's back so far. There's a lot of room there to get that ball in.
Bring up about a fourth down and four.
Have to go here. You're not going to advantage by punting or
right.
a little too far to kick it, I feel like.
Big play here for the Prescott offense. Bullock gives the ball to Hobson. He's on his feet, down inside the five to the 10. Touchdown.
No,
oh, they'll mark him on the one.
Boy.
Oh, man.
Good blocking right there, though. I mean, our guys just nothing fancy at all there. That was right off, two seniors, Mormon and Gully, on that left side. And
oh, he almost got in. I was hoping to see him get in. He's really run the ball hard.
He's probably going to get another shot at it right here, and I don't blame him for letting him get a touch.
Right.
That was a good effort. Now, Josh,
we'll take that one
touchdown.
In with a quarterback sneak.
We'll
1 yard touchdown run that time by Josh Bullock.
We'll keep it here after this with 7 seconds left in the third quarter. Prescott gets out to a lot more comfortable lead, a little commanding lead, and have, other than and that early that turnover that gave them their score, we've played a pretty good half of football up to this point.
Prescott's going to attempt an extra point this time with Marlowe to kick it. And it's no good. We'll keep it here until the end of the quarter. Prescott moves out ahead 24-6. And Gary, right now, they need to get a good kick here and keep Bismarck backed up so we don't give them an opportunity to, get any momentum back that Prescott's been able to gain.
Yeah, I hats off to our line. I mean, there's still some areas to work on, with some of the passing sets as far as giving Josh a little more time. But the run blocking has been a lot better. I mean, it's really been what you expect them to do.
And that's one thing about being on the offensive line. You don't get a lot of glory. You don't get your name in the paper or on the headlines. But they are what makes the difference in a football game. If your offensive line doesn't do its job.
At any level.
That's right.
I mean, if you, from peewee on up, if you just don't have blocking, the best backs, they just can't do anything as hard as they do try.
The running backs and the quarterbacks are only as good as their line lets them to be.
Oh, yeah. Don't help to have a real good running back either.
That's true. Purefoy gets it away. It's going to be picked up about the 14-yard line by Mackey and dropped on the 22.
Sidney Giles, he was the first one a while ago and got right down there again. Just real good coverage, good speed from Sidney. I mean, he's really flying to the football, and that's said earlier, that's what you want. Bismarck, you know, it's about time you think they would maybe get to that alarming stage.
Yeah, because they've got to score a lot in a hurry.
They've got to get some points on the board, and, you know, sometimes when you do that, you get yourself in worse situations, but sometimes you don't. This play should end the third quarter.
Most high school games would be over at this time, and we still got one quarter to play.
Yeah, it's been a terribly long first half. Third quarter's been pretty fast. And they'll have to call a timeout, or they were fishing to get penalized five yards on that. So he was wise enough to avoid getting a penalty on that. Arkansas, they'll jump back into that, going down to Alabama tomorrow. We went, me and Jim went last week and watched the game at Little Rock, and there's some areas to work on there. Mm-hmm. I mean, their offensive line and stuff, they've got a lot of new people, but you have a lot to prove sometimes,
exactly.
You know, when you graduate a lot. But
starting that SEC play, it'll be a tough year for the Razorbacks because they're going to be looked at as one of the contenders.
Yeah, you know, I went to the game at Fayetteville with Alabama last year, and we just really thumped them. And yeah. You know, you remember those being Alabama. I know they're going to. That's something their coaches can really motivate them with, and especially after losing to Louisiana Tech would probably.
Right.
He's trying to keep his job, so he's wanting to really do good. But I look for Arkansas, barring, you know, if Sterner's not so, you know, I think Hampton's pretty good, you know, backup. He looks to have the body for it. But Sterner, he's probably going to play. He's pretty tough.
Well, we're getting ready now to have that last play of the quarter. Prescott leading 24-6 here with just over 3 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
Bismarck a little unsure of what set they need to be in right now.
Myers on the option, pitches the ball to Hartzell. Brad Harris comes up on him, and he'll get him for no gain. That'll end the third quarter. Prescott leading 24-6.
And what are your plans on Thursday night?
I'll be watching In the Press Box on KPSS.
I'm in the press box, Bub and Randy.
I'll be watching In the Press Box every Thursday night.
I've got to have my In the Press Box.
I'll be working out and watching In the Press Box on KTSS.
I can't miss In the Press Box on KTSS.
Join us each Thursday night at 9 o'clock or here on KTSS for In the Press Box.
In the Press Box is a presentation of the fine folks at Hope Auto Company.
I would like to take this opportunity to inform the citizens of Hope and the surrounding areas of our new project. Heather Manor North and Heather Manor South will be consolidating our services. We are very excited about this new venture. The staff here at Heather Manor North will continue to provide the highest quality of care for our elderly. So for health care that's still second to none, contact me, Patricia Eubanks, at Heather Manor North, located at 707 East Greenwood, or call 777-4673.
When you're ready to buy a new car, a truck, a van, or SUV, John Hayes Automotive is your place. Our people are ready to please. We've got great selection, number one service, and prices that are really low. You'll like the way our salesmen treat you, folks you trust and know. So check out our lot, ask about our service, compare our prices today. You'll like what you find in the way that you're treated when you just say John Hayes.
Come see us at I-30 Highway 4, right here in Hope, Arkansas.
Double M Western Store of Hope has a great selection of the latest styles of Western wear for men, women, and children, including Resistall hats, Justin, Tony Lama, and Texas boots, clothing by Lee, Wrangler, Panhandle Slim, and the new 32-inch inseam ladies' lawman jeans. Also, check out our Billy Cook Saddlery and Professional's Choice Sports Medicine for Horses. We also have award-designed belt buckles and jewelry to complete that look. For Western wear, it's Double M Western Store, Highway 4, north of Hope.
Congratulations to the Scrappers for winning the game and winning the bet with the Hope Bobcats. Now McDonald's of Nashville is selling quarter pounders with cheese for only 99 cents for the rest of the month. But don't worry, the Bobcats are still winners, and to celebrate, McDonald's and Hope is selling quarter pounders with cheese for $1.29 for the rest of the month.
From now until the end of September, quarter pounders with cheese are only $1.29 at McDonald's in Hope and only 99 cents at McDonald's in Nashville.
So what you're saying, Steve, is both teams are winners. Yeah, but wait till next year.
Being set now to start our fourth quarter, Prescott leading 24-6. Bismarck will have it second down and 9 from their own 23. And you got to look for them to put the ball in the air, which could make this last a lot longer. Oh, here they go with running the ball.
Good play.
And nowhere to go. Woodley in the backfield to help stop that one up.
And Marlowe there to finish it off. It's Nashville. Heard the score 54-7 over Mena. So, boy, you'll have a Prescott will definitely have a handful next week. And that's always a good football game. I always look forward to doing that. They're always very hospitable when we make that trip over there, and it's a good rivalry.
Ball handed off to Hart, so there's a flag on the play. I don't know what the call was. Woodley on Hobson on the stop.
Speaking of that Nashville game next week, I think they have really got to be not just they're a little more run oriented. It seems to be that McFadden seems to have been playing for.
I think that's an illegal substitution call. I'm not good on my signals as I used to be, but I believe that's what that one is. I had a lot of people ask me at halftime as I was walking down, said, what in the world did they call a while ago on that shovel pass? Because they gave them another down.
It was an incomplete pass, and now they is what the call was.
But they gave them five downs, I think, out of the whole deal.
That wasn't right, but
right.
What the actual call was, which I still think it was the right call, and they might not have got the downs right.
It's going to bring up a fourth down from the Bismarck 25-yard line.
Should get good field position out of this.
They get a good rush. Good punt this time.
Real nice.
Brad Harris will take it on his 40-yard line, cut it upfield with no blockers, but he gets away from them and gets into Bismarck territory and gets out of bounds on, let's see, I believe they're going to mark him on about the 47-yard line. Of Bismarck.
Good effort there. I love to see somebody catch the ball and not let it hit the ground and make positive yardage. Just a hair away from really breaking that one all the way back. You know, Prescott, very likely could continue to try to work on their passing game, or, you know, with a comfortable lead, you've got two different choices. You want to maybe milk the clock if you can.
First and 10, Curly Wolves. Bullock gives the ball off to Hobson right up the gut.
Oh.
And he's on his feet down to about the 30-yard line.
Good hard running. And there again, that was right behind Big 51 and Gully. And you see some of the lines slapping hands, you know.
They played a very good football. The whole line has done well.
And, you know, I think that just comes to the pride factor. You know,
right.
Last week, I mean, I think they'd be the first to admit they didn't have a good ball game. Hey, that makes you want to come out and do something, you know. And their
official timeouts are getting the chain set. First down and 10. Curly Wolves on the Bismarck 29-yard line. Bullock hands the ball to Hobson over the right side. He gets free. He's got one man to beat, and he'll beat him.
He's gonna score.
That'll be a 29-yard touchdown run by Fred Hobson.
Tell you what, Fred's played a good ball game tonight. We were discussing off there who we might pick as our players of the game. We might have to think about it a little longer. We've had some good effort from several people there. There again, a nice hole opened up by the line. Fred kept his head up and noticed where the hole, it didn't really come where he had intended it, but that's where a back can use his vision.
Marlowe to attempt the extra point. High snap. Bullock's going to drop back, look for somebody to throw to. He's got Joseph there. Can't get it to him.
Alertly Mm-hmm. I don't think he was going to get the snap down, so he made a good play to get outside.
10:34 to go in the fourth quarter. Prescott's leading 30-6.
Every day, we all find a way.
A promise made, a promise kept, giving it our best.
NAPA, we're the most complete source for auto parts, and all NAPA parts are backed by a nationwide warranty program. No wonder more Americans trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
We keep America running.
We keep America.
Inside the gift shop at Holly's Health Mart, there's something special to be found for everyone. Come see the large selection of popular Thai Beanie Babies, from the new to the retired, or delight yourself with the enchanting charm of Boyd's Bears, a must for any collector. Holly's Bridal Registry features select dinnerware by Denby, a great gift for the bride and groom. And you'll always find the right expression with greeting cards for any occasion. With that perfect something, come to the gift shop inside Holly's Health Mart in Prescott.
Hometown owned and operated, you can always count on Taylor's Big Star for tailor-made low prices. 7 days a week, you'll find great grocery values in every department and down every single aisle. Big Star brings you garden fresh produce and the finest meat specialty cut to your order. At Taylor's, we work hard to make sure we have the items you're looking for at the lowest price. It's the store that's tailor-made for you. Taylor's Big Star Grocery, Highway 67 North in Prescott.
Since 1904, the Bank of Prescott has been serving our hometown community, offering full-service banking and professional, personalized service. At the Bank of Prescott, we enjoy helping our customers, offering convenient drive-through banking, plus checking and savings accounts, commercial services, and a loan department ready to fill your financing needs. So for hometown service from a hometown bank actively involved in the community, even Curly Wolves go to see the great folks waiting to serve you at the Bank of Prescott. Member FDIC.
In years past, older people who seemed confused or disoriented were often placed in nursing homes where symptoms of depression and other treatable conditions were often ignored. Today, the Golden Care Center at Medical Park Hospital is working to reverse that trend, with a trained staff committed to assisting older adults enhance their quality of life. If you or a loved one age 55 or older are suffering from any of these symptoms, please call us for a free confidential assessment. The Golden Care Center, another way Medical Park Hospital treats you like family.
Prescott Curly Wolves now have pushed their lead out to a 30-6 margin with 10:34 to go in the ball game. We went ahead and clarified our decision there during the timeout. We're going to go with Edward Glenn for our offensive player of the game and Gabe Mormon for the defensive player of the game. Good job by Rico Hopper.
Rico Hopper and Woodley there, boy. Tough lick. He would do good to get. He bounces up. Boy, he got really bent in an awkward way there, but.
Boy, Rico was down there in a hurry, and he put a good lick on him.
Good sophomore. He's going to be a good football player. Glenn had the big touchdown reception, and then, you know, after they scored, came back with the long run that really got the momentum back. And then
I think that was the difference. That right there made the play. And, of course, the offensive line played super. Gabe Mormon has done a good job on the defensive line tonight, getting pressure to the quarterback. Super job by both defense and offensive line. Good stick there by Marlowe.
He's another one that's had his name called a lot tonight on plays.
As well as Sockwell, who was also in on that tackle.
Another sophomore. So, mm-hmm. You know, even we do have quite a few seniors, but we've got quite a host of underclassmen that are really doing a good job for Prescott. 10 minutes exactly left in the ball game.
Second down and about 7. Myers hands the ball off to, boy, I can't get his name. It's Lila Berti.
Nice play, though. A little counter that
get close to a first down.
Very close to a first down. Might even have to have a measurement. He's calling it third down.
Just short. He's got to get up over that 38-yard line. They're right on it.
Third and one.
less than a yard. Myers on the roll out to the left. He's going to throw it deep and almost picked off by Jones. Jones, good coverage. I mean, running right with the receiver.
That was a... might kind of wonder about the play call on their part, you know, a third and a few inches, and Mark Jones just didn't bite at all on that. He's played a good ball game as well. He didn't bite on that for 1 minute, stayed with his person out on the outside, and did a good job.
He's just a junior, and he's done a super job this year by having to play. He's had a lot of passes thrown in his direction during the games that I've noticed. Fourth down, Bismarck will go for it. Myers will keep it, and he should have the first down.
Yeah, he'll get the first, so that will. They'll keep possession for a little while longer.
We can tell that our conference is definitely tough, as Fordyce and Falk are battling it out.
You know, Falk must be a little bit, right. You know, they've shown they're going to be pretty competitive this year.
Fountain Lake and DeQueen were within a touchdown of each other. DeQueen on top at this moment. Myers gives the ball to Hartzell.
Good play there. Keon Sockwell on the tackle. That just goes back to what we were talking about earlier, though, is the games that you're supposed to win, you need to win. I mean, when you're picked and favored, you really have to not let somebody slip up on you, if you could call it that. But
you know, last year it came down to who won between Mena and Prescott when we went to Mena. Basically, who was going to get that fourth position.
You know, they just came out and
that's right.
We didn't have a very good ball game, and that knocked us out of it last year. And Bismarck's the type team that could give some people trouble. We've kind of got into a little groove on them.
Myers drops back to pass. Hit as he throws, and it'll be incomplete. Flemings got to him just as he released the ball.
Incomplete. Yeah, Calvin... that was a lot of the same play that they've used on us tonight, that offside Calvin on that end. Got Coach Crow's German Shepherd on the field.
It's going to bring up a third down and about seven, it looks like. And they're late kind of getting their play in here. I don't know if they're going to make it or not.
Quarterback, he bounced right up. He took a pretty good shot there a while ago on that last play. He's going to have to.
You have to hurry. Myers, a little short drop.
And
Marlowe was right on it.
Boy, Marlowe. Tell you what, I really thought it was fitting to be a completion, and Ralph broke right there at the end, and was just a hair from taking that one back the other way for quite a distance.
That's going to bring up a fourth down and about seven. 7:34 to go here in the ball game. Prescott leading 30-6.
Raphael, just, he's another junior. You know, be back next year. Good player.
Bismarck will punt it this time. Or at least they're back in a punting formation. They do punt it away. Harris will take it about the 31. He gets away from one. He's got a little running room to the right side, and he'll be stopped just short of midfield on about the 47-yard line of Prescott.
Uh-oh, we got somebody. I don't know where it, on what side it was against, but I bet you we got unsportsmanlike on one or the other, and I saw a Bismarck player push one of our players, but I don't know what caused that push,
right.
So we'll just wait and see. We
have a dead ball, personal foul against Bismarck. Yeah, so that'll help Prescott gain a few more yards.
You know, I know as their coaching staff would, you know, you don't want that to start happening on either side. And I didn't see exactly what went on, but
Prescott will have the ball inside the 40-yard line. We'll say on the Bismarck 39 for the first down. And, you know, this is time you want to really keep the ball on the ground, just try to run this clock out.
7:20.
Bullock gives the ball to Woodley around the left side, and he's still on his feet. Good tackle that time.
Yeah, that was a nice play there, 34.
That was Mackey.
He didn't he almost got out of his grasp, but he did a good job to keep him in his hand and lost about a yard. Thought for a minute the way Terry had kind of popped that one to the outside, he had quite a bit of running room.
Second down and 10. Three receivers split to the right. Bullock hands the ball off to Marlowe right up the middle. He's going to break out to the right side, still on his feet. He gets a good block there by Glenn and by Hopper, and he'll get down inside the 15.
Good run. It's the one we picked again, Gabe, on that offensive line. He kind of pulled from his guard position and kicked that off tackle out of the way, and that's really what got the play started. You know, you don't really have to just crush somebody. It's just a matter of being in the right spot at the right time, and that was a good little misdirection play, and Marlowe ran hard.
First and 10, Curly Wolves now on the Bismarck 14-yard line. Hopper in now at tailback. He'll get the handoff from Bullock, and Hopper's on his feet still, and we may have a holding
call. That looks like in the holding area there, and it... He must have been on Gabe because he's holding his arms out like, what did I do there? But that's where the flag hit, was his backside. So I think that's probably where it might have been directed at that time. Prescott using quite a bit of clock, down to 6 minutes. And it'll start back up here in a few minutes. Gabe's getting a well-deserved break right now. He played a good ball game.
It'll be first down now for the Curly Wolves from the Bismarck 25. Get some fresh people in the game now. Bullock drops back to pass, and there's a pass to Sockwell. He's gone.
He just couldn't hang on,
and he knows it, too. He had a touchdown.
I think he saw the goal line before he watched it all the way in. But, hey, Josh was accurate with that one. That hit him right where you wanted to hit you at. He'll catch that one most of the time, and it just didn't quite work, so we'll probably try something again to that effect. Nice call there. They really had Bismarck bunched up inside, and it was open. And it's open again right now,
yes,
because their
is.
Safety's kind of rotated over.
Bullock gives the ball to Marlowe, and he was hit hard right at the line of scrimmage. May have gotten a couple of yards on the carry. They'll have it marked on about the 23, so we'll give him two on the carry. Bring up a third down and, about 18. Inside of 6 minutes now, Prescott leading comfortably right now, 30-6. Would like to work on a few more things before this game is over. Bullock drops back to pass, has time, gets the ball away, and he's got
He's holding there, yeah.
They got the penalty there.
Yeah, because he had a good handful of shirt. I don't know that it would have been catchable anyway, but, hey, you never know if you get held. So.
Yeah, Joey was being held quite a bit on that particular play.
Got good blocking that time. Mm-hmm. He had time to throw the football.
Well, they're mixing it up a little bit now. It's awful hard to, of course, you never know the intensity of what the other team is you know, performing at right now as well, because once you get behind, sometimes you can have a lack of intensity. But still, it's good for Prescott to have an opportunity to work on some things they hadn't been able to so far this year.
Never did get the status of the young man earlier for Bismarck that got hurt. I see a couple guys, you know, out of uniform with their pads off that I hope he's fine. Might have just got a good type of bell ringing type hit.
First and 10, Curly Wolves. Ball handed off to Hopper right up the middle. He's still on his feet. He'll get in the end zone. Touchdown. From 11 yards out.
And this is something I'd really like for it to see us convert here is an extra point. We hadn't been able to do much with it all year long, and it can be crucial, you know, as the year gets on down the line, an extra point can make a difference in a ball game.
Rico's going
to... Just ask Hope.
Right. He's going to be a big-time football player for Prescott, you know, being his 10th grade. He's a hard runner.
Bad snap again. Bullock has time. He's still running. He's got a man open. Sockwell is going to get this one for the two-point conversion. Good job by Josh. He's excited about it, and he ought to be. Two-point conversion is good, and Prescott leads 38-6 with 5:12 to go in the ball game.
Summer is almost over, and that means it's time for school to start and work to begin. The New Hope Auto Company has the perfect new car, SUV, or work truck to fit your every need. And if it's a pre-owned vehicle you're looking for, we have a great selection of quality pre-owned vehicles to choose from. So get out of the heat and get into a great deal at your hometown dealer, the New Hope Auto Company. Highway 4 and I-30 across from Walmart.
Foster's Shoe Store in Hope keeps you in style in all seasons. Right now, ladies will enjoy the variety of Selby, foot cradles, soft spots, trotters, life stride, and more, and select a handbag from Nina Donna, American Angel, or Mark Chantal. And for the men and boys, step out in Stacy Adams Outdoorables or Eastland. Foster's is also your headquarters for children's shoes. From throughout Southwest Arkansas and Texarkana, people are traveling to Foster's in downtown Hope for old-fashioned service and today's latest styles.
The United Way of Greater Texarkana will be at the forefront in making the changes necessary to keep up with modern times. Most of the original service groups remain from last year, many with new faces and a renewed commitment to helping others. It's easy to see how the United Way helps the community by looking at the many organizations and people who directly benefit from your donations. Caring Hearts for Changing Times. That's the slogan for the Year 2000 United Way campaign. You too can be a part of it.
Trees are Arkansas's renewable resource, but children are our most precious resource. That's why Potlatch gives generously to our schools. Computers, innovative programs, a wonderful exhibit at the Museum of Discovery. Their people are active volunteers, too, like Joe Hewitt, a leader in Potlatch's classroom in the forest. 150 acres of hands-on learning about our natural heritage. I'm Marilyn Johnson, principal at Eastside Elementary in Warren. Potlatch people really do make our schools better.
Hello, my name is Lindsay Hill from Mitchell's MediMart, located at 16th and South Main, better known as the 9-Step Drugstore.
What do we mean by 9-Step Drugstore? Parking lot right out front, 9 steps to the pharmacy. We have a post office and a pharmacy here at Mitchell's MediMart. No circling around a big parking lot. Once you bring your prescription cards and your prescription to Mitchell MediMart. No circling around, drive right in.
Don't forget, come and see us at Mitchell's MediMart, 16th and South Main.
Pure 4 getting set to kick it away for the Curly Wolves, who add another touchdown to their totals tonight.
And, you know, this gives them so much confidence going into that game next week.
Short kick, going to be picked up about the 22 by Hartzell, and he breaks it out to the left side. Flemings will slow him up and get him down. There's a late play.
Might have had a late person coming in there a little late on that. Calvin did a good job. Hartzell made a nice play. But, you know, Nashville won so big this week. And, you know, Prescott with a real convincing win. That
another face mask.
And you know, two teams 1-0. So that's a big game. You know, Nashville, you know, you would think the pressure would go a little bit more toward them, you know, because they're being ranked number one.
Number two, aren't they behind McGee?
Maybe so. They're still good.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. I think maybe they are two or one. I think it maybe flops back and forth. I'm not sure exactly. But they're, you know, the pressure's always more on the team that's favored. And and sometimes that's good. Sometimes it's not. I mean, you're not favored for just any reason. I mean,
that's
you're
right
good.
There.
Myers hands the ball off to Hartzell over the left side. Good game.
About 4 yards off the left side. 4:40 left in this one, and Bismarck may be content to just run the football here and, you know, just regroup for, I'm not sure who they go into action against next week, but it will be a conference game somewhere. Could give some teams some trouble, even though the score sounds a little lopsided. I think they have a decent football team.
Second down. Ball handed off to Latiberti. Boy, I just messed that one up.
He's made some good runs tonight. They haven't used him a whole lot, but when he has got his hands on the ball, he's made some nice effort, some runs.
I think I'm just going to stick with Steven.
I would. That's not an easy one to get out.
Ball marked on about the 42-yard line of Prescott.
Clock still running. Prescott, you know, don't want to still has a lot of their main units still out on the field. You know, they need to get all experience and all you can get this time of year.
Myers will hand the ball off to Davis, who will get the first down.
That'll stop it long enough to get the chains moved. Bismarck band really has a good sound to them, and Prescott's playing well.
Yeah, every year I've been very impressed with them. I like their colors, man. They just really look sharp. They had a good halftime show. I watched most of it from close by, and it was very enjoyable. First and 10 now for the Bismarck Lions. Trying to put some more points on the board in their favor. Myers hands the ball off to Davis right up the middle, and he'll gain about 5.
You know, something else that I noticed, and I'm, you know, Prescott's band is quiet and letting them play. And you go, some places you go, that don't happen. You start playing and the other band cranks up. I just always kind of thought that wasn't really appropriate to do that, but.
Kind of give respect to each band.
You know, because, I mean, both bands are good, and, you know, you really don't hear nothing if two are playing against each other.
That's right. It's kind of makes a big racket.
Yeah, it does, you know, and I never have really understood that exactly.
Myers gives the ball to Hartzell over the left side, and he'll gain maybe a couple of yards.
Sockwell there again on the tackle with just a little bit over 2 minutes left in this one, so we're about to get this one run on out, and Bismarck seems to be content to do the same. You know, if they are going to throw it, it'll probably be here.
Third down and about 3. We're under 2 minutes to go now. Prescott leading 38-6, and just a matter of time now before this one can be put down in the books. Trying to let the clock wind down. Myers hands the ball off to
first down.
I want to say that was Davis. That'll stop the clock while they reset the chains. First down. Ball marked on the 28-yard line now of the Curly Wolves. 28-yard line. First down. Drops back to pass, and he'll be stopped there by Flemings.
Calvin, they met several times on that same type play. He just didn't have any time to do anything there. And
he'll lose about 5 on that particular play there, and it'll be...
We are under a minute left in this one.
Fourth down now. Excuse me. Second down. I'm from the Prescott 33-yard line. Prescott will move to 2-2 on the year and 1-0 in conference play. And Bismarck will move to 2-2 and 0-1 in conference play, and there'll be a penalty on Bismarck.
Left end just got in too big of a hurry, 21. And that will stop it with 31 seconds left in the ball game. Just about to wrap this one up.
This one probably will be the last play of the game. If
barring a running out of bounds or something. So Prescott, you know, as they needed to do, you got to win the ones you're supposed to win and let things take care of itself. Just look week to week and play your hardest every time you get on the field.
Three receivers split to the right. Myers gives the ball right up the middle.
And that might do it unless they, you know, choose to stop it, and I really don't think they're going to.
That's
going to
do it. The Prescott Curly Wolves will be victorious tonight over the Bismarck Lions, 38-6.
Where do you go for the best deal on a new car or truck? Your Gary. And where do you find the lowest prices on quality used vehicles? That's right, Your Gary. Once you stop at Your Gary, you'll see why there's no reason to drive anywhere else. You'll find a full line from Chrysler, Plymouth, Dodge, Chevrolet, Olds, Buick, Pontiac, Jeep, and GMC. Your Gary Autoplex always gives you the best deal, the lowest price, and the most experienced service in Southwest Arkansas. To get what you're looking for, you know where to go. The Your Gary Autoplex, Highway 371 West in Nashville.
Okay, Summer, I'd like to hire you, but no diploma, no job. Sorry.
Unlock your future at Hope's Adult Education Center. Earn your GED at your own pace with classes in English and Spanish. With personal instruction, you can receive your high school diploma, learn how to use computers, or English as a second language. Plus, we now offer the WAGE program, a free service that teaches you the skills you need to get a good-paying job. For more information, contact the Adult Education Center at 722-2744. At the First National Bank of Hope, we believe it's important for our employees to be active in the community. From fundraisers to sponsorships, people like Bobby Lowe are happy to lend a helping hand and be partners in your neighborhood.
Hi, I'm Bobby Lowe of the First National Bank of Hope, and I'm proud to be a supporter of our community and the Hope Lions Club. The way I see it, if you're not helping others, you may be missing out on some of the greatest blessings in life. And I'm glad First National Bank of Hope sees it that way too.
A free cellular phone with new activation on a qualified rate plan is yours when you visit your CenturyTel agent in Hope for V-Square Cellular located at DJ's Secure Storage. Find out about a contract rate plan that's suited for you with a prepaid EasyGo plan with no credit check, no contract, and no monthly bill. The phones at Herbie Square Cellular come only with the service of the century, CenturyTel. That's Herbie Square Cellular located at DJ's Secure Storage, 301 West Avenue G behind Fred's in Herbie Square.
Player of the game, Gabe Mormon, who also played a very good job on our...
Okay. It's all right.
Wait a minute. I'm behind the line.
Jim Honey with KTSS Sports now with Gabe Mormon, our defensive player of the game, who also played very well on the offensive line tonight. What'd y'all do a little bit different tonight, Gabe?
Well, we just come out. We dominated pretty much. We come back off a bad week last week against Gurdon, and our attitude was a lot better during practice and had a lot of confidence when we come out in this game. We lost a few players last week. Some things that happened after the game, we looked past that, and we just come out and played as a team.
Looked like tonight y'all played a very good, glad to see you take a stand as a senior there to take charge. Game was pretty tight at halftime. It was 12-0. Did Coach do anything to kind of get y'all spurred on for the second half?
Well, not really. We just, you know, defensive-wise, we just come out, we dominated. I mean, that's what you got to do against a team like that. They wanted to pass the ball, and we shut them down.
Thank you for tonight. We appreciate you. Did a good job.
All right, thanks.
Step on in here, Edward. The game got pretty tight there. It was 12-6, and then all of a sudden we get a big kickoff return after you had one touchdown earlier in the game on a good cut touchdown pass. What made you come to the right? Was that the way it was set up for the return?
Uh-huh. Yeah, it was set up for the right. I was just motivated, wanting to help my team. Just did what I had to do.
Did a very good job also defensively. Y'all had some, they passed the ball quite a bit, and they kind of put some pressure on you.
Mm-hmm. We've been working offense for so long, and Coach Kenny, he's been telling us every day what to do. So it's automatic. We already know what to do. All we got to do is just come out and do it.
Appreciate you being with us, Edward. Congratulations. Did a good job. Now we have the Prescott cheerleaders, and we'll go ahead and let them have a one big cheer here before we close up with Gary and myself. Take it away, girls.
We are the Wolves. We'll knock you out. We're what it's all about. Uh-huh, you got it. We're Prescott. Always on top.
Thank you all for being with us. Gary, the Prescott Curly Wolves get off to a good conference start tonight, going 1-0, and even the record back up to 2-2. Tonight they showed that they can really play with just about anybody.
Well, I thought it was there all along. It's just like we had talked about, some of the mental mistakes they made. They kind of raced those tonight. You know, there's still some things to work on, but that gives you a lot of momentum going into a real good football team you're playing next week in Nashville. You know, it'll be a packed house. Both teams are 1-0. Nashville won big. We won big. So it should be another usual Nashville-Prescott football game. But I think Prescott will compete very well and have a good chance to win the game if they'll play like they're capable of.
We hope to see you next week here in Prescott as the Prescott Curly Wolves will take on the Nashville Scrappers. See you next week.
Curly Wolf Football is a presentation of the Bank of Prescott, Holly's Health Mart, Medical Park Hospital, Napa Auto Parts and Supply, and Taylor's Big Star Grocery. Your announcers for Curly Wolf Football are Jim Honey and Gary Loudermilk.